Hi everyone, we meet again for solving the solutions of exercise 1.2. Question number one says, fill in the blanks. So here I am taking one by one the sub questions. Sub question one goes as follows. We know the A value, D value and N value. We need to find out AN. This is the blank. AN is the blank in the first sub question. So we will use AN formula to find out the value of AN. Let us start with that. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. AN is equal to A, which is 7, plus N minus 1. N is 8 minus 1 into D, which is 3. So further simplification, we get AN is equal to 7 plus 7 into 3, which is next step. AN is equal to 7 plus 21. Finally, AN is equal to 28. So we can now fill in the answer, that is AN is equal to 28. Let us go to question number 2. Second sub question. A is minus 18, we need to find out D, N is 10 and the last term is 0. I use the AN formula. You know AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. AN value is already given as 0, which is equal to minus 18. A value is minus 18 plus N minus 1, which is 10 minus 1 into D. D value we don't know, we'll keep it as it is. Minus 18 comes to the other side, becomes plus 18, which is equal to 10 minus 1, which is 9D. 9 comes to the other side, becomes 18 by 9 is equal to D. 9 ones are, 9 twos are. So D value is 2. Hence we got the value of D. Let's fill it up. 2. Sub question 3. We need to find out the first term A. B is given as minus 3, N is given as 18 and the last term is minus 5. Let us try to find out. I will use the AN formula again. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. See, all the terms here which are available and which has to be found out, all are found within this one single formula. So AN value is minus 5. Pretty easy problem. Direct it is. A don't know. Let it be as it is. N is 18 minus 1 into D, which is minus 3. Now for the simplification, minus 5 is equal to A plus 18 minus 1 is 17. 17 into minus 3. Next step, minus 5 is equal to A plus into minus. This product, this is not subtraction here, this is product. So product of plus into minus, minus 17 multiplied by 3, that is 51. So now what happens next is minus 51 comes to the other side, becomes plus 51. So minus 5 plus 51 is equal to A. That is nothing but now 51 and 5 both are having different signs, so we have to subtract. So if you remove 5 from 51, you get 46. 46 with the bigger number sign. 51 is a bigger number, so the sign remains plus. 46 is equal to A. We got the value of A. We can write up in the blank as 46. Sub question number 4 goes like this. We know A, we know D. We have to find out N. We know last term 3.6 as AN. Now, I will be using AN formula. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. AN value is 3.6 and which is equal to A, that is minus 18.9 plus N. We don't know, we will keep it as it is, into D, which is 2.5. Next step, minus 18.9 comes to the other side, becomes plus 18.9. So 3.6 plus 18.9 is equal to N minus 1 into 2.5. Adding these two after the decimal place, here one place is the 6 and 9. When you add, 9 plus 6 is 15, 1 carry, then 8 plus 1 is 9 plus 3 is 12. 12, one more carry, then 1 plus 1 is 2. So decimal after one place, decimal 22.5 is equal to n minus 1 into 2.5. 2.5 comes to the other side, becomes divided by 2.5. So 22.5 by 2.5, which is equal to n minus 1. Whenever decimals are involved, try to remove the decimal place. That will show you how it is to be done in a working column. Here, 22.5 upon 2.5. Mm-hmm. But remember, you have to multiply both the numerator and denominator with the same number. Otherwise, the value of the fraction changes. So now, just because it is only one place after the point, I multiply both numerator and denominator with 10. So what happens is, this is 225 divided by 25. Now it is simpler for simplification, right? So 5 fives are 20, 2 remaining, 5 fives are. So now it is 45 upon 5. Further, 5 ones are 5, 9s are. Answer is 9. So we know the value of 22.5 by 2.5, that is 9 is equal to n minus 1. Minus 1 comes to the other side, becomes plus 1. So 9 plus 1 is equal to n, which is nothing but 10. So we got the value of n. We can fill it up in the blank. That's it. Fifth sub question, a very easy question actually. When you look at it, it looks like decimals involved, a bigger number of n and all, but you have to concentrate on d. See, when d, difference I have mentioned in the theory part, if difference is positive, then the series goes on increasing. The progression is an increasing progression. If the difference is negative, then the progression is a decreasing one or a descending one. But what happens when it is neutral? It is neither positive nor negative. Then what to do? At that time, the progression remains same, constant. Whatever is the first term remains the second term. Same is the third term, and it's so on. Like first term, if it is A, what is the second term? A. Third term, A. Nothing increases, nothing decreases. So if you just have a look at the first term, 3.5. What should be the next term? 3.5. What will be the next term after that? 3.5. Why? Because the difference is 0. But let us try to find it out using the formula. Now, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So an value we have to find out. So it is an. What is a value? 3.5. Good. Now n is 105. 105 minus 1 into d is 0. Next step, an is equal to 3.5 plus 0 into anything. 105 minus 1 is 104, right? 104. But whenever anything is multiplied by 0, the answer is 0. So this is 0. This whole part becomes 0. Now, what is an? An is equal to 3.5 plus 0 is 3.5. So we got our answer, 3.5. Didn't I say that the number remains same throughout?